The following program contains language, images, and/or subject matter that may be objectionable to some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Direct from Albany, New York, it's time for The Media Zone with your hosts, Ed and Dave. Tonight, a look at this week's new film and DVD releases. And the chance to win free movie tickets with the Poster Pairs game. And now your hosts, Ed and Dave!
Hello, and welcome to the Media Zone. I believe we're in March. We don't have our usual little thing up.
Our prompt isn't up.
Our prompt,
which I know apparently you use. I think I may have used once.
You looked over there once.
I never look over there.
Well, if there's a holiday coming up on March 28th, I don't believe there's any holidays coming up. I believe Easter is in April. I did see the Cadbury eggs were out.
Yeah. I've already had some of those.
Are those $6 a bag, or is that an extra big bag I saw?
That's probably a large bag, but you can get the you can get them on sale sometimes, 2 for $6, or 2 for $7 at the overpriced CVS stores.
Mm-hmm. This was Target, where it's
well, that's usually not
a
bad
bargain.
Walmart, you can get them for maybe $2.98 a bag.
That's the regular bag.
Right.
I must have been a.
But I won't go to Walmart.
You won't go in.
No.
Good prices in that Walmart. You just got to pick your time right. You don't want to get a lot of dregs of society wandering around in there.
You know, I saw this commercial, and I'm thinking of possibly purchasing this item.
Okay.
It's the new Just for Men hair shampoo that as you shampoo, it would darken your hair.
Uh-huh.
I'm thinking of doing that. I'm getting quite gray.
Okay, why don't you try that out?
I don't know. Well, because I only take a shower once every 2 weeks.
Do you shampoo your beard with that, or you have to use standard product?
I don't know. That's just a lost cause.
We know the method we use down here, which is the eyeliner or whatever. Didn't work out that time.
Right. But I'm thinking if you just, every day you shampoo a little bit. It darkens the hair, makes it more natural color. Or whatever.
Do they have? They must have different colors.
I don't know.
For different shampoos, or is it like the old Grecian formula, where it apparently worked with everybody's color, your own natural color came back?
I don't even remember the name of the product. So it's something X.
Is that sold in stores, or we have to order that with a special TV offer?
No, it is sold in stores. Ed.
Okay, well, try that out.
I may have to look for that and see. Maybe I want to go back to my youth.
Does that work on your pubes also?
I don't have any.
Do you have to wear a merkin? American. Okay. Oh, yeah, we'll see. We'll probably say on the bottle what it works on.
Yeah,
your chest hairs, maybe you want to darken those up. Shave them off, whatever you want to do.
I'm sorry if you didn't mention this.
I got to mention everything. By the way, speaking of that thing I just mentioned, apparently Playboy has come back to nudity.
Oh.
As apparently sales were not all that good for a magazine that was based on showing nude females.
Right.
All of a sudden, we're not going to show that. And they expected big ratings and sales, I guess. So nudity is back.
Do people buy that magazine? Do they still print that magazine?
They do print it still.
Do they?
Actually, I got an offer in the mail right before they announced the nudity. I might have to send it in now. That a free year of Playboy. This is how desperate they've become.
And then you can forward it to me.
And then you can use it. pass it around.
As long as I can open it.
Right, the old open the Playboy ploy there. I wonder if they're going to go back where they left off, apparently, or be even more graphic. Do you remember we had the girl that was in the area was the playmate?
Oh, yes.
And we had brought the picture down. We had to cover it up. But it was so graphic, I thought I was giving a gynecological exam. There was no hairs of any kind, and every crevice and crease was shown to full display.
Hmm.
But we got to do some films tonight, Dave.
We do.
We can't think about such things.
You're too late.
We're doing Boss Baby.
Oh.
And we're doing Ghost in the Shell, and we're doing Here Alone, which is a horror.
Maybe not in that order, but that's what
we're doing. Not in that order, but the way I pulled them up here, that's the way I read them.
Yeah.
Let's do Boss Baby first.
All right.
Alec Baldwin, Steve Buscemi, Lisa Kudrow, that's why we've been seeing her around, I guess, lately. Tobey Maguire. Meet a most unusual baby. He wears a suit, speaks with the voice and wits of Alec Baldwin, and stars in the animated comedy DreamWorks' The Boss Baby. The Boss Baby is a hilariously universal story about how a new baby's arrival impacts a family, told from the point of view of a delightfully unreliable narrator, a wildly imaginative seven-year-old named Tim, with a sly, heart-filled message about the importance of family. The Boss Baby is an authentic and broadly appealing original comedy for all ages.
Well, you know what? You can't say it's broadly appealing until you determine if anyone has gone to see it.
Let's see. I barely paid attention to that. Where does it say that? A broadly appealing original comedy.
It was literally the last thing you read.
It was, but I was going on to rated PG. Well, I didn't get there. Yeah. I guess because kids are universally appealing and we like little babies, I guess.
But Alec Baldwin babies?
Yeah, I thought it looked disturbing because it just sounds like Alec Baldwin in the baby. But when you hear this clip, which you won't be doing now, it does look kind of funny.
Okay.
Got that lovely...
Oh, that's nice. Some of my favorite scenes in animation are when the animated critters or whatever are vomiting.
Right, and sniffing.
And sniffing. It's like that was a little human funny... centipede there going on there.
So funny hiney humor in there, too. Not funnier than baby's hinies.
Oh, well, I got news for you. There are things funnier than that. All depends on, you know, what's shooting out of them.
I haven't seen any urine humor yet. I'm sure there's that. I could throw that in. Somebody's getting splashed in the face.
Oh.
Obese child already.
In 3D. You'll have to see that in 3D, Ed, because the colors.
That colors, yeah. They're still grayed out, but, you know, it's better than seeing Prometheus. Is it better gray? Is it better?
Shades of gray.
Everything is grayed out.
Right.
What's next here?
Here Alone. Is this mine?
This is yours.
This stars nobody I've heard of. Lucy Walters, Gina Piersanti, and Adam David Thompson. And if you have three names, you can make it in Hollywood. Deep in New York's upstate wilderness, Anne, a young woman in her late 20s, struggles to survive after a mysterious epidemic decimates society. When her food stores run dangerously low, Anne must make the desperate journey into a nearby town to forage for any remaining food. A chance encounter brings Olivia, a teenage girl, and her injured stepfather, Chris, into Anne's life and regimen of survival, who are trying to go further north, where the infection is supposedly contained. While Anne and Chris grow close, Olivia becomes bitter as an uneasy tension grows. Their lives are threatened when the protective forest is breached by the infected, a.k.a. zombies.
I think I looked this up. It was filmed somewhere in New York. I'm not sure it's a spot I heard of before.
And one that you don't recall.
Yeah, I don't recall where it was now.
Because I probably have heard of it.
You probably have.
Because my...
Siri?
My job, I literally deal with almost every town, village in New York State, so I would probably recognize the name. I may not know where it is, but I probably have recognized the name.
Huh. We'll have to see if the producer can look that up when he's not so busy over there.
Okay.
Susie Griswold. She only does films that are filmed in the Hudson area, or wherever Negan is from, down there, Rhinebeck. It's So they did that Woodstock film down there, and apparently Susie Griswold, our old one-time host, and Negan from The Walking Dead were in that one. I guess he didn't have to travel far if he lives down in Rhinebeck. Yeah, it's the zombies, Dave.
Yeah, that's just kind of what I got out of that read.
We call it infected here.
Yes.
If you go to the IMDb, are you going to talk to Siri? If you go to... What?
What happened?
Are you going to attempt it with Siri? No, you're going to go to IMDb later on. Are you working over there or are you on your phone? Okay. Doc's in, Doc's not in. All right, we have one more film here with Scarlett Johansson.
Ooh.
Ghost in the Shell. Michael Pitt and Juliette Binoche is in this one. In the near future, Major, the first of her kind, a woman saved from a terrible crash who is cyber-enhanced to be a perfect soldier devoted to stopping the world's most dangerous criminals.
RoboCop.
When terrorism reaches a new level that includes the ability to hack into people's minds and control them, Major is uniquely qualified to stop it. As she prepares to face a new enemy, Major, this is quite some name here. Yeah, she's got some.
What? You can't show that?
She discovers that she has been lied to. Her life was not saved, it was stolen. She'll stop at nothing to recover her past and find out who did this to her and stop them before they do it to others.
Oh. There was an attack.
Based on the internationally acclaimed Japanese manga.
Oh, God. Manga?
The Ghost in the Shell. I believe that's how they call it.
Manga? Isn't that a restaurant?
Manga.
Or is it manga?
Is it manga? Is that how they do it?
I don't know.
Say it. I don't know, is she got a suit on or is it digitally? Computer body. If it's her in the suit, that would be interesting to watch once in a while. Especially if she's outside in the cold, 10-degree air like we are. Ghost in the Shell.
No.
Call that. Japanese manga.
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 Manga. Merkin. You to terminate.
I believe this may have been animated at one time. This story.
This almost looks like that movie Lucy that she did.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Well.
3D. Got to see it in 3D. Oh, it's 3D. Too gray.
I can't believe this one's too, looks a little dark for 3D. If you're out there and you're watching movies in 3D and you'll pay the extra $5 or whatever it is, write in and tell us if you're enjoying the experience.
Gary.
Out there. Gary if
Gary.
You're out there.
Is it Gary? Is it Bob? Who is he? I keep forgetting.
That
is
was a
Gary?
Mystery. We
did solve it at one point.
We delve into it, you know, every once in a while.
It's Gary.
Somehow he had to hide his identity for some reason. We do that by just not including our last names in the credits. But he goes by a totally different name, which is Gary.
But that's not... he's not really Gary?
That's not his real name. I was thinking down in our final season...
Bring him down.
I think we should bring Gary down, and either if he wants to appear on the show, he can turn the board over here, or if he just wants to watch, he can sit.
I'm sure that's a lifelong ambition.
I think he would like to see, from watching this way back into maybe even screen scenes times.
He did write a very nice email, though.
He did write one, and he might just want to watch the show from our guest recliner over here. We'll bring him down. We'll bring stagehand Tony back for a final appearance if we can get Kim, the matinee lady. Apparently very busy across the street there. She's right across Central Ave here.
I didn't know that she's that close.
We can't get her over here. Yeah.
But yeah, he did write a very nice email. I was very touched by that.
Would you like to touch me?
Like
what was that from? A sketch we did.
It was very touching, nice email. I appreciate that. for him to say such nice things.
Yeah, take a few minutes and write in if you're enjoying the show. We give you the email address in a few minutes. If you're not writing in to play the game for free tickets, I don't know why. It takes a couple seconds.
Because they don't watch the show, that's why.
They watch. I know there's people. If you've never written into the show before, yeah, we don't always explain what to do. That's why I'm doing it now.
Why start now?
Let's get a bigger response in the final penultimates and finals seasons.
Well, I know you in penultimate, but I technically think this is our last season. I know you say season doesn't start until September, but we're really in coming up to the final year, 12 months.
Well, that's a different thing to say.
We'll do calendar 12 months. We're in our final 12-month calendar, starting with the next show.
Now, the producer, of course, will stop production before he has to pack up here, because I'm looking around, there's 500 paint cans over here. He's got to do something with them.
Yeah, might be a couple interesting colors I might want to take back to my house.
Now, do you have an official date when you're leaving the state? Are you not quite sure? You're just going to shut...
I'm not sure. Probably October.
Probably October.
Do you have a place yet?
No.
No. So you're going to go there and be homeless until you find something?
Check up with people.
Now, which city are you going to?
He doesn't know.
Because the Bunny Ranch is out there somewhere, isn't it? What state are you going? It's Arizona you're going to?
Maybe Florida first.
Oh, this is the first I'm hearing this.
This is a different schedule.
I've known this man for 50 years, and I'm not even getting information. Kenny, you win $20,000 at a casino, I can't get a pizza. What the hell? Friendship for you.
We do get pizza when we taped earlier. Maybe you weren't here for this.
Yeah, well, pizza we get taped. We get frozen Walmart pizza for a guy who gets $20,000, and then he goes to the casinos again, and he's winning $900, $400, comes home. I'll stop when I get down to $1,000.
Well, what did you pick up at that new Schenectady casino, other than dead bodies, which seem to be piling up down there? How much did you win? You won some money? $200. That's 200. A nice takeaway.
Who wins? I go with $20. I'm out in 2 minutes. These guys go. Oh, all of a sudden, I look down and it says $900. Oh, I just paid off my brand new truck because I won $20,000.
Well, I guess we're gonna have to take him down with us because I don't know what to do in a casino.
Oh, I have no idea what to do with those things.
Online.
Who does?
You hit a button. Don't. You don't have to put money in there. Not the money. I know people play money ones. I guess it's legal at the moment.
I don't know how this crap works. This was $1, 10 cent, 50 cent, $5. He goes into the high, goes, I look for the high roller room. Yeah, what's what you win? Well, I can't afford high roller room.
I went to casinos once under protest in 1985 when we went to Atlantic City.
Oh.
Or did we? Yeah, Atlantic City, somewhere in Wildwood we went to.
Oh, that's right.
And we traveled to Atlantic City, and I still have the Trump little coin thing, plastic things you keep your coins in.
Ah.
Which is probably worth big bucks now.
Well, there's something.
Probably more than I ever won at the Trump casino.
Have you been to Saratoga Racino?
No, I haven't been to the Racino. What?
Me? No.
Not once?
Oh. No. I've been to, I don't even know if it's Turning Stone recently for an Alice Cooper concert last year. Foxwood, that's where I went, yeah. And I did do a couple machines, but I'm sitting there like, you know, like Warren Beatty. I'm like, how do you do this?
Do you pull coins in there?
I think you get a card. Yeah, voucher thing, yeah.
Like a credit card thing, you run it through there and you put money on it or something?
No.
No. You get a voucher.
You pay for a voucher, I guess you
scan it in,
and then... You know, they suck you in because, you know, I put in like a $20 voucher and all of a sudden it's 28, 32,
ooh.
24,
uh-oh.
18, ooh. 26,
oh.
17, mm. 24, 14.
Keep it going. You gotta get it up there.
Look, it's going up. Next thing you know, three.
Oh.
Then you're like, forget it. And then you go and you say, I'm going to cash in this $3 and get a drink with the drinks are $8.
Jesus.
Is it time for DVD releases?
It is. We're about 5 minutes late, but we have no other material, so that's fine.
Okay.
We did the deaths. We didn't do the deaths.
We did last show.
We did deaths.
Yeah, remember, he was upset about George the Animal Steel.
Right. He didn't make it.
Fantastic Beasts.
And Where to Find Them. The 3D version.
Aren't they all 3D?
No. This is 3D. I don't know who still has a 3D TV and player.
Oh, right.
Yes. Digital HD Blu-ray.
This
Blu-ray
is the again. Guy who played Stephen Hawking.
Oh, is it?
Eddie Redmayne?
Something like that? Yeah, you could be right. I don't know. Yeah.
Fantastic Beasts. And if you want to get the special collector's edition with a little beast, you can get that for about $120, I think. Ooh. Very pricey, these bonus creatures.
Ooh, Phantasm. Wasn't that from like 79-ish, the original?
Yes. This is the collection. I think there may be six of them in the whole set. Now, I looked around. I think there is a ball in this collection. I couldn't find a picture, though.
As part of the
set, when it opens up, I believe there's a full ball in there.
Oh.
So, if that turns up again, we'll show that, the ball. He's holding a ball there.
He's holding a ball. Another collection.
I don't think I've seen any of the Wishmasters, if there's four of them, or...
I haven't seen any of them, even if there was one of them.
And see the first one.
Clearly there is four.
Four film set, yes. Not four disc set.
Right.
So there's four films in there. This was just out.
Oh.
Bless you.
And it stars Sigourney Weaver and Liam Neeson as what?
The monster. Hunk of wood? And it's certified fresh on the tomatoes. Ooh. I wonder how Kong did. Was it certified fresh?
What is a fresh certification? Is there a baser limit?
I think it's over 90% with critics.
That's
reviews.
Very fresh.
That's a fresh tomato.
Wouldn't 80% be fresh? Because I only get, when I go to Price Chopper, if it's 60% fresh, I consider that a good day.
That's a good day at Price Chopper. I haven't heard a lot about Price Chopper lately.
Blow up.
This is the film during the TCM Oscar month where I was watching, Blazing Saddles right at the beginning. And I fell asleep right at the end of Blazing Saddles and I woke up an hour or two later and there is nude breasts on the screen.
You can't do that on TCM.
You can at that late hour.
Oh.
Apparently there was another film, A Room with a View, on there. Where there was male members, Sean.
No.
Dancing around.
Come on.
Yes. Male members. Room with a View. I'll have to look that one up.
There you go.
Now, we have a couple minutes. Can you go to the IMDb on your phone?
Sure.
And find out.
Here Alone?
Here Alone, and it'll give you the locations where it was shot.
Okay. And we'll see if I've heard of this.
Now, I don't think I heard of where it was. Usually, if something is shot in the area, these local actors, in quotes, all over the area will be in it. But it didn't have any of these typical local actors.
So maybe it was very upstate or
it was very up
south upstate.
Or low, but it wasn't.
Basically, anything outside New York City they call upstate.
Yes.
Which isn't necessarily close to where we are. But we'll just sit here and...
Here we go.
Here we go.
What do you got?
Corning, New York.
That's
okay.
It.
Corning.
Cameron Mills, New York. Savona, New York. Watkins Glen, New York.
Yep.
Dundee, New York. Whoa. And Gibson, New York.
Okay, Watkins, I heard. Where
Watkins
is that?
Glen.
Is that south? That's all south stuff?
No, Watkins Glen is north. Corning, isn't that where they do the glass?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Corning Museum, I believe that's north.
I think you've blown...
I've been there.
You've blown things in there, right?
I have.
We had video of you blowing.
I have, yeah.
Right in the glass there.
Yeah. All right, game!
So that's all north. They shot that, but it escaped, apparently, the low-budget actors we have in the area.
I think Watkins Glen might be somewhere around one of the Finger Lakes as well.
There's a race car.
Yeah, yeah. But I think it's near the Finger Lakes. I could be wrong.
Get a hold of Barrel Ass Buzz. He'll tell us where that was. All right.
Time for the poster paired game, folks, where you send in two numbers from 1 to 6. We select your entry, reveal what's behind the two numbers you give us, and if they match, you win 2 free movie passes. If you're right, spin the wheel like Michelle Crisafulli did last week. We would spin the wheel, and you could win up to 10 tickets, but Michelle didn't win because she didn't match. But she did right spin the wheel. That's kind of the point I was making there.
Huh. We have one more show after this taping.
Okay.
So let's get a winner today or on the next show.
Okay. We'll try.
We had a big run there where people were winning 10 and 6 tickets.
Yep. And I used to feel bad for the producer, but I don't anymore.
There's plenty of budget, apparently.
Well, guess what? It's Michelle Crisafulli.
Okay.
Again. And she's doing the old side-by-side ploy, 5 and 6.
Five and six this time.
Last time she did 1 and 2.
That didn't work because it was up and down last time. But now we're doing the side-by-side maybe this time.
And spin the wheel. This could have big potential.
Grip. Oh, not this time. What do we got going on here?
Not the up and down ploy again.
Wasn't it up and down last time?
Only moved.
But different ones.
Wow.
Maybe next time.
Trickery.
Well, how are these determined? It's by the roll of the dice, right? Or some computer generated...
That's what I don't understand.
Random.
I don't understand why he needs a computer. Just grab him and move him. Put him wherever you want.
You would think so, but it's by a random process.
Yeah. Well, that's random.
I say leave it like this every week and we still won't give tickets away.
That's probably true. If you want, I don't know why the camera's on me, but if you want to win, this is what you do. You send in your Mint entry by email to MediaZone95@gmail.com. Watch Kong Jerk. It's MediaZone95@gmail.com.
Should I redo that?
Yeah,
no.
It's too late.
I might do it.
Yeah, penultimate. And if we take your entry and the two numbers you give us, it reveals a match, you win 2 free movie passes. If you write spin the wheel like Michelle did, we will spin the wheel where you can win up to 10 tickets. Or you can lose them both. That's the risk you take, folks. That's what you do. I'm not going through all that other crap.
I don't know why I didn't think of it, but when we did Kong on the show, why didn't we wheel out the Kong? It's like 10 feet from here. We should have wheeled him out for that.
Probably because he's two colors.
Yeah.
Doesn't really work well. And has like a, or at least in that segment, a little clip on his finger.
Sets to hold the thing on. He wouldn't have, he's not holding it.
He doesn't
anything.
Have the clip there?
No, if we had a banana, we could put a banana in there.
Of course, you can't really tell that he's two colors.
No, not in the lighting.
But he's definitely two colors.
We'll have to make a trip up there early in the season to the House of Frankenstein.
Oh, we have to for our final season.
And then maybe towards the end of something for Halloween we could do up Ooh. There. We'll do a couple things up there
sure.
while we can. And then after that, for the all-new.
The all-new
media
show.
Zone, we won't be leaving.
We don't leave a room.
Even wherever we are, even our chair, right. We can set up one of those.
We don't even have to wear pants.
We can do that live. I will remember last time I told you, we are getting the word out on how to shoot video with
yes.
your phone.
Yes.
And not only did we get Trishna Begum
yes.
to shoot the correct way, we also got from our class Jill Palmer.
Oh, really?
Who's vacationing in Florida or somewhere, shooting lovely shots.
Did she thank you for the advice?
She liked it. She liked my comment. I said, okay. Ooh, vertical or horizontal. Because I wrote, oh, vertical. Lovely shots of this beach and the white sand, and we're seeing this much of it. And now it's lovely horizontal.
You've done your civic duty.
I'm getting the word out there because the people who are taking the time to shoot this video might, by God, put it in the correct format so we can see it in all its widescreen glory now that we have widescreen. So next time, what do we have, Dave?
I don't know.
Going in Style, which is a remake. Do you remember the original Going in Style?
No.
Their Finest. And Smurfs. We're doing Smurfs again.
More Smurfs.
More Smurfs, and then I think we have a funny DVD trailer.
Oh, okay.
From the 70s. It's interesting. So we'll see you next time.
Watch me change my shirt.
The Media Zone has been a Cable 2000 production.